In this video, I'm going to show you how to do neural manipulation for tibial nerve. It's on posterior part of leg, and this muscle innervates calf muscle and foot muscle. So this is very, very important place. Why? Because on middle part, there's no big muscle, such as hamstrings and gastrocnemius. These muscles go lateral part and medial part. No big muscle is on midline. So this is very, very fragile part. There is only the fat tissue, nerve, artery, and lymphatic system. So this is very fragile place. Imagine tibial nerve runs like this. So I approach to this part on supine position. Once I start working on tibial nerve, you don't see exact hand placement. So imagine I am on midline. Okay, imagine I'm working and I put two thumbs here. Okay, remember, my two thumbs are gonna be on midline. Now I'm going to show you on supine position. Now this person is on knee flexed position and hip flexed position, about 90 degrees and 90 degrees. Remember, my two thumbs are gonna be on midline or posterior part of knee. See, you don't see my exact hand placement. So imagine from first part, I put two thumbs on midline, then I pull tibial nerve this way, distally, okay, this way. Then a little bit off, nervous tissue starts to move, I follow movement. This is exaggeration. This is very tiny, tiny movement. However nervous tissue moves, you follow this, okay? I put two thumbs midline, put stimulus this way, little bit off. Nervous tissue starts to move, you follow movement. If I exaggerate, it's like this. Good. This is very good for knee pain, especially on posterior part. You see that I make a little bit hip movement and knee movement to assist movement of nervous tissue. It's very good. Again, I put two thumbs on midline, put stimulus this way, exaggeration, little bit off, nerve starts to move, then you follow nervous tissue until it finishes movement. Again, this is very good for knee pain on posterior part. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.